Namaste YouTube, welcome to Enoma. We are going to give our reaction to War Paint by Rush. Got an interesting title. Let's see what it is about.
Come on.
Should I have been, instead of war paint, I think it should have been the mirror always lies. Isn't it? Because that's the core point in this song, the mirror always lies. We have heard from ages that mirror never lies. Shows you the exact reflection of what you show. But the mirror has no brains of its own. It sees what you want to show it, isn't it? As you want to see in it and as you do things, that's exactly what it can show you back. It doesn't, you know, it can't see through what's inside of your skin deep beauty. It just can't see anything beyond the skin. It can't see what your intentions are, what you have done to manipulate what you see in it. So, it's not lying actually, but it doesn't understand most of it. It's just being used to see what it shows. It is just being used. And I like the lines, just, well, let's paint the mirror black because it's lying all the time. It's not the mirror who's lying, it is us who lie all the time to ourselves. Even when we are seeing our reflection in something else, we want it to be something that we want it to be. It's not that it is what it is supposed to be or what it in real life. People who watch our videos, they think that we only know the things that much we speak in a video.
Can you repeat that again?
Yeah, a lot of people who, watch
just
our videos.
Just in case the guys are listening in the corner.
Watch our videos, they think that our knowledge is only the spoken words that we have spoken in a particular video, but you have to remember that this is the selected words that we use to speak in a video, and it's just one video related to one song, one topic that the song is talking about. We aren't discussing anything else outside this realm or outside the circle that we try to bind ourselves within while reacting to a particular song by a particular band or a musician. That's all we talk about. We do not talk about the knowledge that we may have about X, Y, Z or other facets of life or other facets of anything, any industry at all. So just to think that we might be dumb because we only spoke that much, it is about the time, that the limited time that we can interact with each other. So you have to think a little beyond that, that we might not be that dumb just because we didn't say anything beyond what you may just heard. That's all. The reason why I sit and do reactions to several musicians, several bands, which are completely different, they aren't connected at times. And it is very difficult to do for a person who didn't listen to much music, Western music at all. You know that for the fact that because of the upbringing, because of the background, because of the family, customs and things like that, most Indian children or the normal people don't really get too much involved in Western music and things of the West. We have our own things going around and we have a lot of them, there is a huge market and there is a huge supply too, so we don't really get time to seek something outside. But I remember, and why I'm mentioning that, because me doing all these things could have stopped me from doing it. Why do I need to do? I don't have to get into all this. But we had this teacher, a very mature teacher, very good teacher, who also, for me, was kind of a mentor when we were in school. I'm saying we because the entire batch liked him a lot and we had a great rapport with each other. He would have been somewhere between, 9th and 10th grade when we were, And that age is very, very crucial in your life because at that time you start understanding things. You are somewhere near maturity. Your the way of thinking and everything is much better than your childhood days. And he would talk about different things. We would discuss, we would study less of the subject that he was supposed to be teaching us. But he would be talking more about the life and things like that. And at times we would be discussing something like religion or something. And I would get very offended if we were discussing something which I didn't like in the class. And he saw that uncomfort, the uneasiness of me. And and I was one of the brightest students. He wanted to, give a message, though he gave it to the entire class, that you should listen. You should listen to everything. Must not close your ears just because you think you might not like something. Listen to everything. Following it or believing in it comes much later. There is no compulsion that you have to follow something that you heard or that you just watched or that you just got exposed to. You don't have to. That choice comes later. The first choice is the liberal choice. It's a choice that you make that you are open to everything. You must listen to anything. It can be any talk. You just make that effort to listen, because that expands the way you look at things. And that openness in you that I am willing to see what it is. After that, you like it or don't like it, that comes later.
So you're talking to a group of people who perhaps have very, very limited exposure. And this is not about you personally. It's about most people in the world right now have very limited exposure. So because of that limited exposure,
and because no teacher told them that,
and they are looking at the same mirror every single day.
Yes.
And the problem with that is that there are two problems. One problem is that you are completely fine with looking at the same mirror every single day.
Yeah.
That is the biggest problem, when you don't even realize that you have a problem.
Yeah.
And the second aspect of this is that just because you're so comfortable and used to this mirror in front of you, looking at the same face every day in that mirror,
mm-hmm.
you just don't want to blacken that mirror, you don't want to smash that mirror, you don't want to buy a new mirror, and you do not want to change your landscape around you, because you're so used to fitting inside that dark little box. You're so used to being stuck in a little black hole. You would rather be stuck there for the rest of your life, because for you, as long as you are comfortable in that little black hole, you are happy. So you think that is all that matters. But trust me, today when I say this, right at the end of this reaction, there will come a time when you will be praying and even regretting that you wished you had watched this particular reaction a lot more closely, and many other reactions that we have done a lot more closely, without letting your cultural biases, educational biases, background biases come into the picture and putting that mirror between us, so that you cannot even see beyond the mirror. You can only see a reflection of yourself. So no matter what we say and do and speak and listen, Kirti is absolutely right. So I'll end this reaction with something she said, so that she will not end it this time. Just because we only speak on certain things during a reaction does not mean that we are stuck in a little black hole, just like most of the world is. It is thanks to people like us that we even know that there is a black hole.
I don't see beauty as a
I'm not saying that I'm too beautiful, but I'm certainly very, very wise. In fact, many people tell me, students have told me, my own relatives told me while I was growing up too, that I'm far, far wiser than my years. So they have always told me, in fact, it's a very common thing when I go for a corporate seminar,
that's not a vanity,
and walk through a door, they see a ugly, fat guy like me walking through the door, mostly dressed in a t-shirt. Yes, this is exactly what I wear to corporate seminars too. So they are really, really shocked, because their background is that little black hole that they work in, live in, do everything in. So when they see someone from outside that black hole enter their hole, coming in completely different from what they imagined, much younger than what they expected. But at the end of the day, they were the ones who called me there. I didn't go begging. They were the ones who called me there. And they called me there because somewhere, somewhere outside that little black hole told them, someone told them that I was pretty good at the work that I did and what they wanted me to do when I came there. So when we do this reaction, I know that I'm pretty wise for my own boots. That is why I don't even wear boots. I usually wear slippers, I usually wear sandals, which are very popular in India, because I believe I'm too wise for my boots. But just because I'm too wise for my boots doesn't mean that I stop learning, stop exploring, stop seeing beyond the window, stop looking beyond the horizon. In fact, I have learned that the more that I learn something new each day, the more I want to learn something new tomorrow. So, at the end of the day, I apologize. I apologize for having offended you. I have apologized for having given my own interpretation on reactions to the songs we react to. I apologize for being honest before you interrupt. Hasn't your culture taught you not to interrupt people? The fact is, I apologize for doing something that no one else is doing, which is giving an honest take on what I just heard, based on what I know and what I aspire to know. I already know a lot, but I want to know a lot more. So when I sit in this reaction, I do it for me. I am selfish, I am self-centered, I am what I am. I do not need a mirror to tell me what I am, or someone else to tell me what I am. It only wastes everybody's time. And I hope someday you will see what I said during this reaction, what she said during this reaction. I hope someday you will have the time to sit and listen to it without distractions and accept it with an open mind. I love this song and I'm very grateful to Rush. Very grateful to Rush for opening my eyes today. Without being counselors, without being psychotherapists, without being certified life coaches, without being so many other things, I'm so happy that they taught me a valuable lesson today. And that lesson is, be proud of who you are. That is the lesson I got from this song. Be proud of who you are. Do not put down others just because you haven't achieved what they have. That's what I have to say. Goodbye.
In the meanwhile, we analyze the song as it should happen. Thanks for watching.